Hey everyone, my name is Mica Dugan and I'm from the Sacramento Jazz Education Foundation. I'm excited to share with you another great lesson from our vault. In this video, I'm going to talk about some of the most important mental aspects to consider before you begin creating or improvising. While this is geared towards a musician who is inexperienced or too afraid to improvise, these same lessons can apply to more seasoned players learning new concepts. Think of it as your daily affirmations before you practice, create, or improvise. It does not stand for failure. It stands for first attempt in learning. You will possibly make millions of mistakes in your lifetime. Use it as a way to move forward and not let it cripple your ability to take chances and create. Don't linger on tiny mistakes while you're playing. Keep going and think of the big picture, as most people won't even remember a missed note or wrong note that you might have played. A favorite quote of mine from a gentleman by the name of Scott Adams. It is, "Creativity is allowing yourself to make mistakes. Art is knowing which ones to keep." And that couldn't be more true when it comes to creating and improvising through music. So don't be afraid of mistakes. It's one of the processes in how to learn. You've probably heard before or something very similar to it. There are no wrong notes, only wrong resolutions. If you find yourself playing a note that doesn't sound good to you or is really uncomfortable, you're only a note away from playing something that works. So whether that's up or down a note in your chord progression, or your scale, or your key signature, you're most likely going to find a note that works. So have confidence in that note and resolve it to one that works and make it intentional. Most likely your audience won't know. The fourth thing we're going to explore is confidence. Having confidence in your sound, which includes good technique, good tone, and pitch, will make even the simplest things sound good as long as they are convincing. The great Louis Armstrong was known to play just quarter notes at the beginning of his solos, but they still sounded great because he backed it up with confidence, which included air support and a good sound. Once you move beyond the practice room, surround yourself with those that will support and encourage you so that you have a place where you can learn, grow, and create that's free of judgment. Whether it's people in your band, your teacher, or whoever your audience may be, having these things are very important to your development as a creative person and as an improviser. Thank you for tuning in and listening. We hope you enjoyed all of these tips and hope that you use them to reaffirm yourself every day that you pick up your horn to create.